Once you realize you can do anything, you're free. You could fly. You could fly. Nobody can touch you. Nobody.
But today I think I'm going to be driving to the refinery in Salt Lake. Going to be hitting some nice chest. No, actually not chest. Pardon me. I think I'm going to be hitting some shoulders and biceps today. Maybe a little bit of back because I hit back yesterday, but it wasn't the greatest workout. But yeah, just wanted to check in. I know it's been a minute since I've honestly been recording, but wanted to start the new year off right. Want to try and stay a little more consistent with this as much as I can. I think Ryan might be coming to the refinery with me. I'm not 100% sure. But lately I have been getting asked what I eat. Right now, since I'm bulking, I'm close to about 199. Well, yes, like the other day I weighed in at 199.5. And then I'm trying to get up to 200, so I'm pretty friggin' close, but that's after like a full day of eating. I kind of want to be waking up in the morning and be about 200 flat, even when I'm dehydrated, but that's kind of what I'm fluctuating around. I think it's really hard for me to kind of break past that barrier, but I'm pushing myself to the limit, to be honest. I think my gut has been, it's been kind of going through it since I've been eating a shit ton lately, but right now this is what I'm eating. Camera will focus on it. May not look the greatest over the camera, but this is about a half pound. This is half a pound of ground beef. It's 96.4, 96 lean, 4% fat. Then I'm eating an over easy egg, a little bit of cheese, and a half a cup of rice. This is usually what I eat before I work out, and it's honestly pretty good. I don't mind it. It's not bad. I usually eat this about, what time is it right now? It's about 11:16, so pretty early, still almost noon. But this is what I like to have, usually around the afternoons. In the mornings when I wake up, I'm not super hungry in the morning, so I usually eat something light. I'll probably eat about like a tiny bit of overnight oats, just drink a lot of water. And then when I really get hungry, this is kind of about like my second meal throughout the day. But yeah, if you try to put on size, I think this is a really good way to go. Got a lot of protein in it.
Question.
But we'll rock this. Camera can zoom up on it. Rock the Lulus, Nike socks. And bam, touch up on this hoodie. We looking fresh, ready. I bet. We'll see y'all there. Just got here. It was about a 40 minute drive from my house. This is what the main entrance looks like. It's pretty sick. I mean, hopefully they let us film and stuff. I'm not 100% sure if I know Max and like other content creators have filmed here before. I've never been here. This is obviously is my first time. So we'll just have to see how it goes and stuff. Hopefully they're cool with it. I don't want to get anyone in the shots. I don't need Joey Swole coming after my ass and, you know, canceling me. But this is what I'm mixing in today. Gonna get a little bit of honey. Just a little dosage of this. Hold that over. I usually hold it for like 5 seconds over and just squeeze it. You know, I don't really have like a certain amount. I just count to five and then I'm, yeah. I have to put in this plastic baggie because it was getting everything in my backpack like really sticky. So I guess just like
I have this little pouch right here that holds like some candy because I like to eat candy at the gym. Like I got this Elf candy cane candy, but it was like making my other bags of candy really sticky and stuff. So I just had to put it in here and it's whatever now. Gotta let some air out. In here, gonna mix some Himalayan salt. This is so the pump goes freaking crazy. And then, oh, I got Sebum's pre-workout. Shout out to Gunny. That dude got me all this shit for Christmas. So, it was a good holiday. Mix this in. I'm gonna probably take like, not as big of a scoop as usual. Gonna take like that much. It's still good enough. I don't dry scoop just because I've seen the health benefits and stuff. Definitely mix your pre into your water. I've seen that dry scooping is not good, so definitely don't want to be fucking dying. I'm just gonna put a little bit of Himalayan salt in that. That's good. Grab the lid. Mix that shit up. And hopefully it's a good ass pump. Grab that. But yeah, man, I'm actually pretty hyped to get into this gym. I think it'll be sick. It looks surprisingly like smaller on the outside. I mean, it's got a warehouse build for, I mean, obviously it isn't a warehouse, but like there's like three different units. So there's like the body mechanic, there's like Fulton. I don't know. There's like different, like they're kind of like their own section, and then Refinery is just in the middle, and it looks smaller than I thought. Just because I go to the Vasa, and Vasas are usually pretty big, but I have been told that this gym's like really big and it's like one of the best. It's like the best in Utah, or one of the best. Don't quote me on that. So I guess we'll just see what it's all about. But yeah, I'm gonna kill this. Kill that. Ugh. Wash that down with some water. Hopefully they don't kick my ass out once they see the camera. But I'm gonna try and get as much footage as I can. It is my first time here, so I don't really wanna have them get all pissed and stuff. I'm sure I look like a newbie for sure too.
I did lat pull downs as a warm up, but there were people around me, so I didn't really want to film. But then I saw that, like, there's just random tripods everywhere around here, and people will just pick them up and just film themselves. So I was like, yeah, I'll whip out the camera, see what's up. But so far, this gym's actually hella nice. I like it a lot. It's empty, but I mean, it is like 2 p.m, so no one's here right now. But it's pretty nice. They don't have the low row machines. I guess, like, they don't have a lot of, like, it's kind of hard to describe. Not, like, necessarily, like, free weight machines, because I'm in the free weight section, but, like, it's more kind of, like, assisted, like, machines, you know? So, like, on barbell, like, bench, they only have, like, one of those, but a majority of them are, like, assisted, and more so you can, like, focus on your form and stuff. That way you get, like, the best, like, muscle contraction, and when you get, like, you just focus on the muscle a lot more rather than trying to focus on, like, balance when you're going down. They have a lot of those machines here, but it's really, really cool here. I like it a lot. I think I might have to come back and film another time, but I did a little bit of shoulders over there on that red machine. I think that one's new, that red machine that I filmed earlier on. It's super nice, but right now I'm just doing a couple hammer curls. I don't know what else I'm gonna do. I think I'm gonna do 3 sets still failure on this, and then we'll just decide what we do next after this, but yeah, let's keep it going. I'm gonna have to grab heavier weight. Pretty heavy. I don't know what I'm gonna do after this. Might have to take funnel raises, and then I think we'll just call it there. I've been here for about an hour already. Set. So I know I said I did the back pull downs when I got here, but I'm just gonna do it with a finisher just because they were kind of like a warm up when I first got here, just to kind of ease into the gym. I had a little bit of anxiety when I pulled up. I'm not gonna lie, I saw a lot of people. There wasn't like a lot of people, but it's like it's a new gym. I see like no people that I recognize. I saw like this bodybuilder here though. He has like 1.7 million followers on Instagram. Let me see if I can find him really quick. Show you. It was Nick Walker. I saw Nick Walker here. As soon as I pulled up, he showed up about like 5-10 minutes after me. But he's fucking huge. I saw him and I got a little intimidated, not gonna lie. But see, these are like the tripods that I was talking about. He was having them out. I saw Nick like pick up a tripod and he just started recording himself. I was like, fuck it, like, I'll just bust out the camera, like, I might as well. I drove, like, 40 minutes to get here, but super cool, super mellow. He's back there, he just walked past. But it's super cool, super mellow. I'm just gonna go ahead and finish these off. I'm just gonna do the lat pull downs. Today consisted of, let's see what I start off with. So lat pull downs, some shoulder press, free weight shoulder press, dumbbell shoulder press. Then I did dumbbell lateral raises. Just spam those because I'm trying to grow my shoulders right now. I feel like I've been lacking on them a lot. And then I did the machine bicep curl, preacher curls. Then I went ahead and did the machine assisted shoulder press. And that's what I got on camera. Then I've just been doing curls. Gonna do a little bit of back. I don't know, I don't really think I have anything else in mind. I think I should be good. I gotta do legs tomorrow just because I skipped legs on Monday. I didn't come. I mean, it was the new year and honestly, I kind of spaced it. But yeah, let's finish off with these and let's go check out the pump after this. And I think we'll call it good. Let's do three of these. So, one wide. Activate my lat. Push down. Homies and my little brother. Do one close grip overhand. They got like a wall of grips over here.
Oh yeah.
Like all these, the ropes. It's sick. I'm gonna go somewhere real quick.
Do it on cables, but I don't know.
gonna do one underhand. I'll do one face, I'll do like three sets of face pulls, and then we'll call it good. I'm actually done after face pulls.
Unfortunately, we can't pose here. So let's go check out upstairs.
So this is the posing room that they have upstairs. Let's see what it's all about. This looks fucking sick.
But yeah, check out the new tripod.
And like I was saying, how they have random tripods. We got those two right there.
It was honestly a good day. I mean, you can still see it. Oh, just flexing on the fucking on the freeway right now. But yeah, I'll definitely be back for sure. It is the 4th of January. To be honest, I mean, the pump was nice, but I'm kind of getting tired of this whole bulking shit. To be honest, it's been. My body dysmorphia has been probably the worst it ever has been, to be honest. I've just been fucking, like, I bought a mirror for my room, and like, oh man, just the body dysmorphia that comes with it is just like, it's horrible right now. So I'm ready to slim down. I think I might give my bulk like another month. I know I didn't really record a lot of it in the winter, but I'll try to record like what I eat and stuff. But right now I'm just, oh man, it's been fucking terrible, to be honest. I hate, like, there's pros and cons to a bulk. You get hella strong, you gain a lot of strength. Like the other day on bench, I was hitting like 225 for 8. Like, I've never done that, and it was moving like really smoothly. I was with Calvin. It's like, it's the smoothest like 225 has ever moved for me. So I think it's cool, but just like the look and stuff, I mean, I go into a cut, then I'll be like, fuck, like, I'm just being hella strong. It's just a never-ending cycle, to be honest. But it's fun. That's why I stick to it. I like it. I love the gym. It's really great. But, yeah, man, I think I'm going to be done with my bulk here in about a month. I'll give it about a month, see how I feel. I might try to slim down, might pick up on cardio for the next couple of weeks. I'm going to try and maintain my strength. Hopefully, I can still keep it. But that's just kind of where I'm standing right now. I have a lot of better goals for 2024's goals. Another goal is that the Refinery, they're holding a bodybuilding competition. And it's literally for like beginners. So like people that have like no experience like at all, that's what it's for. But it's not associated with like the NPC pros or like any stuff like that, which is cool. It's more just for like fun. But I want to try it, test my knowledge, see how far I can go and stuff. I have a really good support system. Like, all my friends are
telling me to go for it and stuff. So right now I'm just, I want to be entering in that. That's kind of my main motivator right now to get past this bulk, because I know like it's just, this bulk is part of the process. Like, it may fucking suck looking like shit right now, but I know if I'm getting stronger, I'm doing it right. Because if you're not getting, so if you're on a bulk and you're not gaining strength, then you just kind of look like shit, you're eating like shit, like, you know, you're not really doing anything right. So I've been trying to keep track of like my progress and stuff. Like, I have a little journal, I've been writing down my workouts, seeing just what works best for me right now. And honestly, I've been making more progress. I feel like my buys have honestly grown a lot lately. But yeah, that's my main, that's one of my goals for 2024, is to hold, to, not the hold, but to go to that bodybuilding competition. I wanna try and test my physique. And if I do good and if I liked it, I'm probably gonna enter like an NPC Pro, try to see, like, especially for people that are new to the gym, like, we've all been there. Everyone gets anxiety when they go. Like, I remember my first time going, it was with me, Ryan, and Alfonso. And I remember Alfonso was the one that got me into it. And all three of us would go together. So we just had a routine, like, yo, let's go at this time, let's go at this time. And I remember the first day I went alone, I had so much anxiety when I walked in. And I decided to take a couple deep breaths. And just remember like my routine. I was like, okay, like, what do? I do my warm up. I did like 10 minutes on the treadmill, and then I just slowly got into the weights, warmed up, you know, got the blood flowing and everything. And then my anxiety went away, and then I just started going after it. And that's what I recommend for all the people that are honestly going into the gyms for January for their New Year's resolutions. Like, just chill. Like, I know it's easier said than done, but I promise you, like, no one's there judging you, and if they are, they're fucking dickheads. Because I mean, I was really scrawny when I went in. I see a lot of like other skinny kids. I remember one time I was at Fossa, and some kid came up to me and was like, hey man, like, I'm new to the gym, like, I just want to see like what you have in mind on like what I could do. He's like, I don't really know a lot of the machines. And I was honestly surprised he even came up and talked to me. And I was like, yeah, I was like, for sure, like, what do you want to work out? And he was, I think he said he was training like back and buys, or like he just wanted to know like what was a good split to work that day. So I just gave him my split, and I just told him, I was like, you know, write these down, like, you could even do these, you could do that. And he was a super cool kid. I haven't seen him since, but hopefully I didn't fuck him over. But he was a really cool kid, and I think people should do that rather than just kind of hating. I mean, I know the gyms are busy right now. I mean, it's New Year's, everyone's trying to get their resolutions in and try to better themselves, and I think that's what we should do, is just help people, especially if they don't know what they're doing, you know, make people feel welcome. Like, I felt very welcome at the Refinery. Like, I was a little nervous, but people were super nice to me and stuff. Like I said, I met those three people. So yeah, I just say, just try to help like anyone that seems new to the gym this year. And, you know, we want to make everyone just feel welcome. I think it's cool. I mean, I was once in a beginner's shoes, so I know the anxiety that comes with it, but luckily I had my friends there to help me through it. And then, you know, you'll just get more comfortable with time. You really will.
All right, so I'm finally home. Let's see if my ground beef is defrosted. Yep, it has defrosted. That's good. Okay, I think now I'll be making, let's see. Oh,
got some chicken and rice meal prep.
I do believe in the 20-30 minute window that you have to eat your protein in, but unfortunately I was like literally an hour away just because I was driving back home from Salt Lake, and then I had to drive to my little brother's indoor game, so that took a minute. So hopefully, as long as we're getting our food in, I think we should be fine, to be honest. Hope that's the case. What do you want, huh? Say hi again. I want your food. But yeah, I'm gonna cook that up. Oh, this is what I usually use.
Bucked up.
This is what I usually have. I got two different flavors.
I got this chocolate one right now, but this one's mint chocolate chip. So, yeah, this one still hasn't, I haven't even opened this one because I got this on the Black Friday deal. So, 25 grams of protein per scoop. So, I usually do like a scoop and a half with my meal. I'll definitely be bloated as fuck when I'm done eating this, but yeah. Normally I do, on my cut, I always grab the Fairlife, the fat-free meal, just because that shit's pretty clutch. But right now I'm rocking with 2% fat milk. Put that up to like right here. Throw that all in the fridge. You know you gotta shake the Let's see if any girls home. Not hot yet. Microwave fucking sucks, I swear. You throw that, you can throw a meal in for like 10 minutes, it'll still come out cold. This is what I'll have again tomorrow. I usually just cut down the middle, and that's just half. It's 1 pound. So just cut down the middle, it's half a pound. So eat one of those for lunch, and then probably for like a post-workout meal. It's pretty nice to just get in. Yeah, that's my meal. Gotta chug this shit really quick. Chug some of that. Dude, those pump pictures that I took just went crazy nice. I had a lot of veins popping out of my forearms and shit. Look crazy. Yeah, I think we'll end it here. I'll show you guys my meal really quick, and then I will end the video. Let's see, that looks good. So my girlfriend actually made me this. She likes to meal prep. She's pretty fucking goated like that. Oh, that smells fucking fire. So this has got like chicken and rice in it. It's hella gas. I don't know the macros on this, unfortunately, but it looks pretty healthy to me, so I think it should be good. That's actually fucking fire. Pretty killed it. Well, I'm gonna go to my room. I'm gonna start editing. Hopefully we can get this video out as soon as possible. But thank you for watching if you honestly have made it this far. That was hot. We'll see you next time.